Hi students, good morning. Welcome back to our geography class. In this year, we already studied about India's size and location, India's physical division, and we were discussing about India's drainage system. The entire system, entire river system in a region is called drainage. The entire river system in a region is called drainage. While studying about Indian drainage system, we saw the drainage pattern, the which way the rivers are flowing, that we call the drainage pattern. The drainage pattern, we see that there are different drainage pattern, such as, do you remember what are the drainage pattern we studied in the last class? If the rivers and its branches are looking like the trees, that what we call the river and its tributaries are looking like the branches of tree, what we call, do you remember? The drainage rivers, its tributaries are looking like the trees, the branches of tree, that drainage system we are called dendritic drainage system. Dendritic. The next one we call that the trellis drainage system. Dendritic, trellis. Then again we see that the rectangular river system, and finally we see that the radial river system. These are the river pattern, the way in which the rivers are flowing. And one more thing we see that one river, it flows more than one pattern, means somewhere the rivers may be the dendritic system and somewhere it may be the radial system, like the different river pattern, same river it may follow, that also we see. And while we are discussing about the Indian drainage system, especially today we are going to discuss about the Indian drainage system. While discussing about Indian drainage system, we see that Indian drainage system, it is divided into two parts. There are two kinds of rivers are there in India. One is called the Himalayan river system, and the next one is called Peninsular river system. Himalayan river system and Peninsular river system. Himalayan river system means the rivers originate from Himalayas, and the next one is called Peninsular river. Inside India it is originating, Peninsular river system. It is mostly originating from Peninsular plateau. And there are differences between Peninsular river system and Himalayan river system, that also we learn in the last classes. Today we are going to discussing about the Himalayan river system. Today we are going to discussing about Himalayan river system. Himalayan river system. Today we are going to discuss about Himalayan river system. There are three Himalayan river system in India. There are three Himalayan river system. Indus river system. Indus river system. Next one is Ganga river system. And the third one is Brahmaputra river system. Brahmaputra river system. Before going to the topic, please remember what is river system. One river and its tributaries. One river and its tributaries are together called river system. For example, Indus river system is river Indus and its tributaries. How much square kilometer, how much area it is drained by this river, this is called river system. In the case of Indus river system, nearby 11 lakh square kilometer, more than 11 lakh square kilometer land is drained by Indus river and its tributaries. 11 lakh square kilometer. And river Indus, it is flowing. River Indus. Today we are going to discuss about Indus river system. Indus river system. Indus river system. Today we are going to study about Indus river system. Indus river, it flows nearby 2900 kilometer. It flows 2900 kilometer, 1140 kilometer in India. it flows in India. 1140 km river Indus, it is flows in India. According to 1960 Indus Water Treaty Agreement, India can utilize 20% of Indus River water. 20% of river water India can utilize. This water is utilized for the irrigation facilities of Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh. So let's tell river Indus river system. Indus, one of the important Himalayan river, Indus River system. Let's study about Indus River system. Remember, river Indus, it originated from Tibet. Origin is not from India, it is originated from Tibet. Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. Clearly, northwestern part of Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. River Indus, it originated from Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. Just we can mark in the map, say this is the outline map of India, then this is Bay of Bengal, then this is Arabian Sea. So river Indus, it is originated from Manasarovar Lake in Tibet Sea. This is Manasarovar Lake. From here it is originating as a two small branch sea. Then this is Manasarovar Lake. It originates Manasarovar Lake from India. Then it is flowing towards the west, northwest sea. It is flowing towards the west. It enters in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Now it is called the Ladakh region. Earlier, the Ladakh, it was a district of Jammu and Kashmir. Now Ladakh is a separate union territory. So here in the Ladakh, then when it is enter into Ladakh, it create a gorge picturesque. Gorge means when the river is flowing, the bed is eroded, the land become more deep. Likewise, it enter in Jammu and Kashmir, then it create a picturesque gorge. Then further it is flowing towards the northwest in Jammu and Kashmir. Then it is completely the mountain and valley region. Then it is reaching in this region. In this region it is called Gilgit. Gilgit. Then Balochistan. Gilgit and Balkot. Then it is entering in Pakistan. See, here this is called Attock. 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 Till Attock, it is moving through the mountainous region. Then Attock, it is emerging to the plain. Indus Plain. From here, it is starting the Indus Plain. Then Attock, then flowing through the to south through Pakistan. See, this way it is flowing. Okay, then listen, this is a Jammu and Kashmir. In Jammu and Kashmir, many tributaries are there. These tributaries are joined with River Indus, such as Shylock, River Hansa, Nubra, River Shylock, River Hansa, River Nubra, and River Saska. These are the four tributaries of River Indus. It is joined in Jammu and Kashmir. Shylock River. I think recently you heard about India-China skirmishes in Galwan region, in Galwan River, in Galwan valleys. The River Galwan, it is a tributary of River Shylock. And River Shylock is a tributary of River Indus. So in Kashmir region, Shylock, Hansa, Nubra and Saska, these are the tributaries joined with River Indus. See, here river in this region, then here river, this is river Shylock is coming, Hansa is coming,
Saskar Lobera, it is coming likewise. The different region in Kashmir, the rivers, it is joining with River Indus. So this is called River Indus. Indus River. Remember, once again, remember in which, see, it is originating from Manasarovar Lake in Tibet, flowing towards the west, northwest. It is entering in India in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Now, not Jammu and Kashmir, now it is in Ladakh. Ladakh is the Union Territory. Earlier, in your book, it is given Ladakh district in Jammu and Kashmir. Then here it is creating the picturesque gorge and moving through the valleys or mountain valleys. It is reaching to Gilgit region, then Balkot, Gilgit region, then it is reaching to Attock. Till Attock, it is moving through the mountainous and valleys, mountain and valleys region. Then from here, it is entering into the plain region, the plain. Then now it is in Pakistan, the plain region. Then that important tributaries, River Indus in Kashmir, once again, River Shailok, River Hansa, River Nubra and River Saskar. These are the tributaries joining with River Indus in Kashmir. Then again, when it is reaching Pakistan, then many Indian tributaries are meeting with River Indus. From India, many Indian tributaries are meeting with River Indus. One is called Satluj. The next one is called Bias. The next one is called River Ravi. Satluj, Bias, Ravi. The next one is called Chenab. And next one is called Jhelum. Once again, Satluj, Bias, Ravi, Chenab and Jhelum. These are the tributaries meeting with River Indus. All these tributaries are flowing from India. Okay, see, first of all, River Satluj. Thus, River Satluj, we see that River Indus originated from Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. See, this is the northwestern part of Manasarovar Lake. Then River Satluj, it is originating from Manasarovar same lake, the southern part, southwestern part of Manasarovar Lake. River Satluj is originating and it is also flowing towards the west and entering into India. See, this way it is entering in India in the state of Uttarakhand. South of Kashmir, then north of Uttarakhand it is entering, then this way it is coming. Then next one is River Bias. See, from here, River Bias. Let me write there. This is Satluj. Remember, Satluj is originating from Manasarovar Lake. Then this one is called River Bias. Both are meeting here. Then another one is called Sea. Then both are flowing. See this way, through the Pakistan it is flowing. Then next one is called River Ravi. River Ravi, it is, see, this way it is coming. Then next one is called River Chenab. Let me write there. River Ravi River. The next one is called, see, River Chenab. And last Chenab. The next one is called River Jhelum. See, this is coming to the border. See, now all these rivers are coming together. See, these five rivers are coming together and it is meeting with River Indus in Mithankot. Mithankot in Pakistan. See, all these tributaries, five important rivers in India. Then this is joining with together, all these rivers together joining with River Indus in Mithankot in Pakistan. Then it is further moving towards the south. Moving further towards the south, then it is reaching to Arabian Sea. It is bifurcated, then it is reaching to Arabian Sea. This is Arabian Sea, it is reaching Arabian Sea near Karachi in Pakistan. Near Karachi, it is joining in Arabian Sea near Karachi in Pakistan is joining Arabian Sea. While flowing, we see the river Indus. It is flowing nearby 2,900 km and it is nearby 11 lakh square kilometers. See, this Indus and its tributaries, which are the area it is drained. Then beside this, many, many small streams are there, small rivers are also there. Then all this area, it is drained by river Indus, means entire Pakistan, then the state of Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, then Himachal Pradesh. So these are the state drained by river Indus. So this area is together 11 lakh square kilometer. Then total length is nearby 2,900 kilometer. In India, it is flowing 1,114 kilometer. It is flowing, river Indus is mainly flowing the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Then other rivers are there, river means Satluj originating from Manasarovar Lake. Then other rivers are originating from Himachal Pradesh and going through Punjab and entering Pakistan. And these all five tributaries meeting with river Indus in Pakistan in Mithankot, further flowing to south and joining Arabian Sea. This is called Indus River System. What is river system? One single river and its tributary is called river system. Now you see that these many rivers are there. All these rivers are the tributary of river Indus. That is why this area India is called Indus River System. This is one of the important Himalayan river system, Indus River System. Once again, Indus River System, river important points, remember, river Indus originated from Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. See, northwestern part of Manasarovar Lake. Then southwestern Satluj is flowing. Then other important tributaries. Remember the important points. Remember from where it is originating, Manasarovar Lake in Tibet. Then earlier in India, it was Jammu and Kashmir. At present, Ladakh. Then picturesque God is creating. Then in Gilgit areas, it is entering to Pakistan. Till Attock, it is moving to the mountainous region. Then here it is entering to the plain. Then in Mithankot, it is meeting with other Indian tributaries, such as Chalam, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. Then important tributaries is Jammu and Kashmir, once again remember. Then Shaldok, then Hansa, Nubra and Saska are important tributaries. Then this Indus and its tributary is called Indus River System. See, this is one of the important Himalayan river. Then Himalayan river system, another important Himalayan river system, let's study about the estimates. Thank you.